we got going on here. Yep, whoop, 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 whoop. It's the blowfish. You know how you cook them?
Yeah. You cut them right behind the head.
Yeah.
And then you just take the skin and you peel it.
Yeah.
You peel it all the way back.
Uh-huh.
And then it's like a little, it's almost like you're eating wings. You can coat them and deep fry them.
I think we're going to try what that guy said. Little chicken wing style. Nope. Oh, we got a little ting, ting, ting. We're tinging. We're tinging. Blowfish City. Fat boy.
What up, big boy?
Back.
That's what he said. Cut it just right behind the gill, pull the whole skin back, cut off the tail, and fry it.
It's
supposed to be
good.
It's supposed to be, yeah. I'm gonna try it out.
It's a big one.
Jesus.
Look at you.
Alright, back home, all showered and cleaned up, feeling good, getting ready to clean these puffer fish. Now, full disclosure, and you know this, it's the first time at attempting to do this. I was catching them in a previous video and I was throwing them right back, and most of the comments that I got on Instagram, YouTube, even from fellow fishermen were, why would you do that? These things are absolutely delicious. And being as it is my first try, I watched a lot of videos, I talked to a lot of fellow anglers, and the consensus is that these are one of the easiest fish to clean. We'll see about that. And one of the tastiest, we'll also see about that. So if I can do it for the first time, you guys can do it too. So the way it was explained to me, we'll take the big boy first, right? The way it was explained to me is you go and you feel for the back of the skull, which is right here. Take a sharp knife, and you go ahead and you make a cut. All the way, you just want to cut through the spine. There we are. Then, at least the way it was explained to me, this meat is supposed to peel, the skin peel, you can already see it's peeling. The skin will peel right on back. I'm going to make this cut just a little bit bigger on the skin. And I even saw a video where a guy scrapes the back of it, pulls down the skin a little bit, you hit it with the fork, and then you pull. And what that's supposed to, what that's supposed to do, the meat's supposed to come right out. But it really does just kind of pull right out. Well, that's it. That's a blowfish fillet. All the nasties and the gookies, they all kind of stay with the head. So okay, once again, back of the skull. Make the cut through the spine. Pull the skin back. hit it with the fork, pull up. You gotta be kidding me, that's it? That's it. That's it. Through the spine, peel the skin back a little bit, stick it, and rip it. All right, guys, here we go. This is what they look like all cleaned up. Clipped the top and bottom fins with a pair of clipper shears. This looks like it's going to be delicious. I mean, this looks just like any other fish that I would eat. And in fact, tomorrow is game day. And I've been told that cooked properly, these are like the chicken wings of the sea. So tomorrow's Philadelphia Eagles game day. I actually saw a recipe for beer battered blowfish by a Baltimore Ravens fan. And if it comes from Baltimore, you don't have to fact check it. It's delicious. So we're going to prepare for Philadelphia Eagles game day. I'm going to serve it to my parents, but I'm not going to tell them what they're eating. So you will get an unbiased opinion on beer battered blowfish. I can't wait. All right, so it is game day and we got all our ingredients ready. We're ready to make this recipe. My dad's behind the counter, so I can't tell you what I'm making, but it's gonna be a little bit of a surprise for him. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna throw in one egg into the bowl. And this is a recipe I picked up off of YouTube from a Baltimore Ravens fan. I'm gonna put the link below to give him a shout out. Because it really is. It really does sound good. All right, so we got our egg all beat up. We are going Miller time on the beer. We're making our beer batter. Yeah. Mix that up. We're gonna add a cup of flour. Now we're gonna start spicing it up a little bit. There are measurements to this recipe, but just like my Italian grandmother used to do, she never measured shit. So we're just going for it. I like a lot of spice. So we're gonna give it some pepper. We're gonna give it the old garlic powder. We're gonna give it some salt. Seafood lover, Old Bay. You got to do the Old Bay. All right, so first thing we're going to do is we're going to take our bluefish and we're going to give it a light dusting of flour. Get it in our beer batter. I'm just gonna get this all up in there. Look how good that looks. Yeah. Get it in our beer batter. That around. All right, so it's done. I'm not gonna tell you what it is. It's about 5 minutes before kickoff, so I need a taste test and a verdict like quick. So go ahead, dig in, try it. I'm not going to tell you what it is until you eat it.
That's good. What is that?
You like it, Cheryl?
Mm-hmm.
Know what it is?
What?
You want to take a guess, Gordon? I think Gordon's got it.
Blowfish.
No way.
Yeah, it's pufferfish.
Is it?
Is it really?
Are you supposed to eat blowfish?
It is good.
Well, it's not poisonous. Like, there's a Japanese one that's not. I'm not poisoning everybody. Everybody's going to be fine. Nobody's going to call 911. But yeah, deep fried beer batter blowfish.
Yeah.
So would you eat it again?
Yeah. Oh, absolutely.
Would you eat this again?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Delicious.
It's actually very good. The way you prepared it is very good.
Delicioso.
You deep fried it.